first possession of the night. They go right to left. KU wearing their road blue tonight. Duke in their home white. Nadir Tharp slings it left side now to Wiggins for a jumper. Doesn't go. Rebound kept alive by Perry Ellis, but taken by Duke. So the Blue Devils have it. Jabari Parker, who's from Chicago, brings it up the court. He shoots it and missed it. And they tip it out to Parker. Now in low it goes. And a shot is in by Emil Jefferson and a foul on Kansas.
Yeah, forced the bad three by Parker. Tip out, and Kansas kind of took off, lost Jefferson underneath. And definitely a bump by Wayne Selden in the bucket. So not a great start as Andrew missed the 15-footer.
Here's the 6'9 Jefferson to try to make it a three-point play for Duke. And the foul shot goes in. It's 3-0, Blue Devils. Full court pressure as point guard Quinn Cook is guarding Nadir in backcourt, and Nadir gets it across the midcourt line. He goes left side with a pass intended for Wiggins, but knocked out of bounds by Rodney Hood.
Well, we know one thing about Coach K. Coach teams, they like to pressure the lanes, and that was a long pass by Nadir. Got to be careful on every pass.
In the opening minute, 3-0 Duke. Here's Tharp with the ball. Left side it comes to Selden for a jumper. Missed. Rebound Duke. Pulled out of there by Emil Jefferson. So the Jayhawks 0-for-2 here to start the game.
But a couple of open looks. You'll take it.
With the basketball, Rodney Hood, the transfer from Mississippi State. He's guarded by Wiggins. Pull-up jumper. Missing off the lip. Rebound Kansas. Selden got it, and he's fouled by the Duke player, Tyler Thornton.
Good challenge by Andrew. Got up as Rodney Hood pulled up from about 18. He was leaking out. If Kansas could have secured that ball, he would have had an easy bucket.
Okay, you'll have it in backcourt. Nadir Tariq Black will throw it in to Nadir Tharp. Nadir again guarded by Quinn Cook. That's going to be a good matchup, those two junior point guards. Tharp, who set out the game the other night against Louisiana at Monroe. Right side Wiggins with sporting the new short haircut. And Nadir's got it out top. Trying to go in that lane. Puts up a shot. Won't go. Rebound Duke. And now they lose it out of bounds. And a foul called on Kansas.
Yeah, they got Tariq Black. I think if they would have kept possession, they wouldn't have called that foul.
So it'll be Duke's ball at midcourt. Jabari Parker will play it in. And to Quinn Cook. Bill Self standing. We're KU bench down to this end of the floor. Pass inside, an easy bucket to Quinn Cook. 5-0 Duke.
Simple. UCLA cut. Nadir turned his head. Duke took advantage.
2 minutes almost into the ball game. 5-0 the Dukies. Michigan State jumped out in their game 10-0 and eventually won it by 4 over Kentucky. Tariq Black, left side, Tharp. Gets it over the top pass to Perry Ellis, who had it knocked out of his hands out of bounds. It'll stay with Kansas.
Yeah, got to get the bigs involved. So far, you've had two jump shots and a deer driving to the basket, so I'd like to see Perry or Tark get involved.
Jayhawks 0-for-3 to start the game. They're down 5-0 here early. They get it inbounds in the right corner. To Tharp, their deer brings it to the point. 10 on the shot clock. Have to go to work. Tharp right of the lane. Plays in the lane. Now Perry Ellis lays it in to the left hand.
Nice ball movement that time. Nadir turned the shot down. So did Wayne Selden. Simple bounce pass to Perry Ellis for the first bucket of the night.
5-2 Duke. Duke leads the all-time series 7-2 against the Jayhawks. Cook's got it out front. Over to Jefferson. Whistle. And a foul.
That's two quick ones on Tark.
Oh, boy.
Yep, going to bring Jamari Traylor off the bench, but he definitely put his hands on him.
You're not supposed to do that now, even though it's not a lot of contact. It's the new, it's not the new rule, it's now the enforced rule.
Yeah, it's not an emphasis, it's a rule, as yeah, we were corrected the other night by Keith Richard.
That's right. 17-20 to play first half. Here's Duke. Hood with the ball. They get it back out of the perimeter now to Quinn Cook. 24 to shoot. Now left side, Parker had it knocked away. Perry Ellis gets it. On his back, he throws it over to Traylor. Up the floor they come. Left side, a bad pass. Nadir trying to get it on the baseline to Andrew Wiggins, and it goes out of bounds.
Yeah, good defense by Perry. Started it, got on the ground, and Nadir just let it slip through his hands.
Nadir's got to be a stabilizing force at that point guard spot.
Hasn't been a starter. Every time you step up in stature, look at Perry Ellis.
Perry Ellis with the ball knocked away, but Duke gets it back.
Well, when you step up, you got to be ready to take care of the basketball. And there's Perry went for the steal, allowed Hood in the left corner to knock down a three.
So Hood with his first bucket, and it's 8-2 Duke. Ellis in the lane, can't score. Rebound, Duke. Here they come on the run. Jabari Parker, left side, Cook, jumper, missing. Rebound, Kansas. Ellis got it. Outlet pass, a bouncer, goes to Tharp. Now bad pass by Nadir. Here comes Parker the other way, and he missed. Rebound on the deck. Duke gets it out front. Jefferson shoots and misses. Rebound pulled out of there by Wayne Seldon for Kansas. Duke now 3 out of 8, KU 1 out of 5. A three for Seldon. Good for Kansas.
Nice turn down that time. The trailer was Wayne Seldon, knocked down a three in transition. Kansas needed that.
Seldon, one of the many great prospects of the freshman class around the country.
He's kind of the forgotten one, going to get a holdout top. I think they're going to get Nadir, another ticky-tack foul. That's now 4 team fouls on the Jayhawks.
Wow. And a timeout. Bob Davis with Greg Gurley, producer-engineer Bob Newton, 8-5 Duke. Little disparity in fouls early on. KU with 4 personal fouls. Duke with just 1. The KU fouls, Seldon, Tharp, and 2 on Tarik Black, who had to come out of the ballgame.
Yeah, a couple of those were just wrong place, wrong time, but a couple were putting their hands on him, and that's what got Tarik Black the second time, and be interesting to see if Bill Self, when he goes back with Tarik Black.
And interesting that he came with the more experienced Jamari Traylor rather than Joel Embiid.
Yep. Well, I think this game is going to be, with the way the Dukies can put the ball on the floor and dribble by you, it's going to be difficult for Joel. But he's definitely going to play.
There's a drive in the lane and a basket good by Quinn Cook.
Well, that was just too easy. That was just a simple pick and roll. Nobody hedged. Get all the way to the basket.
10-5, Duke. Wayne Seldon plays it out to Wiggins. Wiggins heads into the lane. A spin move and a shot. Bouncing off, but a foul. Blocking foul on Duke. Oh, and Krzyzewski is irate.
Look at Coach K. He is not happy. Well, the NCAA changed a lot of rules, and they also emphasized flopping, and
fouls on Rashid Suleiman, who came in off the bench,
who would start for about 99% of other programs, him coming off the bench.
He's had a history of playing a quote-unquote starter off the bench, and that's the case with this guy.
When we see this box score at the end of the game, Suleiman, and how is that not 2 shots, though? Kansas is going to have the ball out of bounds.
Oh, yeah, I thought he was shooting.
Maybe that was their way to appease Coach K.
Oh, is that part of the deal? There's Seldon, puts his man in the air, but doesn't shoot. KU down 10-5 here with 15-20 playing the half. Tharp in the lane. Got it. Got the roll, and Nadir has his first bucket, and it's 10-7.
Well, they're bringing that man from the other side, not allowing the post feed to Perry Ellis, so Nadir took the opportunity with the wide open lane and got his first bucket.
Duke with the ball. Suleiman out front. Josh Hairston's also in their lineup now. He's a 6'8 senior. Hood is still in. Shot from the left side doesn't go by Parker. Rebound Kansas.
Good job by Perry Ellis against Jabari Parker on the perimeter.
Trying to get it inside, but it's stolen by Parker. Duke's got it. Now they throw it away. KU get it right back.
Yeah, trying to find Perry underneath, and too many turnovers early on in this game for the Jayhawks.
KU with the 3 turnovers thus far. It's 10-7. Duke on top, 14-30 to play in the first half here in Chicago. Tharp up the court against Quinn Cook. Bounce pass right side, Wayne Seldon. Out top of the circle to Jamari Traylor. Over to Tharp. Pass inside, Perry Ellis, and a pushing off foul on Duke before Perry can take it to the bucket.
A nice set that time. They little misdirection. They work the ball around. Perry Ellis seals. Duke's forced to hold. Good set play.
Allen Jefferson, his first. KU will play it in with a new shot clock. 10-7 Duke. And it comes to Traylor.
Oh.
And Wiggins for a dunk.
Saw a little backdoor cut. They overplayed. If they're going to overplay, cut back. Andrew Wiggins with his first bucket here in Chicago.
Packed house here at the United Center. Nearly 22,000. Here's Suleiman, top of the circle, into the lane, out to Cook on the side. He brings it to the point, guarded by Nadir Tharp. Inside 14 minutes to play, first half, Duke by one. A high post now to Jefferson. Here's Hood with the ball on Brunner. Blocked by Traylor, taken by Kansas. Hawks a chance for their first lead. Pass in the lane and a dunk by Jamari.
Started by Jamari, finished by Jamari. He brings instant energy to this team. Kansas with a one-point lead.
You think there's some KU fans here?
Bill's pushing the right buttons. First big off the bench, Jamari Traylor.
Here's a shot from out front. Off the lip, no good. It's out of bounds to Kansas. On the miss by the Dukies, Rashid Suleiman. KU gets the ball in backcourt, leading by one. 13:22 to play in the first half. Duke's got a new man up front, Marshall Plumlee, the 7-foot sophomore. Yet another Plumlee brother playing for Duke. Here comes Nadir Tharp against Cook. KU by a point. Here's Nadir trying to move. He plays out front Jamari. Over on the side to Wiggins, who's double-teamed. Wiggins to Jamari, who couldn't catch it. It goes out of bounds.
Kansas got to do a better job of handling the pressure. That was a simple double team. Andrew panicked a little bit and fired a fastball up at Jamari, and fourth turnover for the Jayhawks.
Perry Ellis comes out as Joel Embiid comes in.
Good time to put him in. 13:06, going to get him a good minute and a half before the next media timeout. Get his legs under him. And he gets the guard Plumlee.
11-10. KU pass in the lane, and a shot didn't go, but a foul on Wiggins, I think. Stewart with a foul call.
That was all started with Jabari Parker in the post. Joel came to double-team. That left Plumlee a wide-open lane down the middle. And again, I'm not sure why that wasn't a shooting foul either. But ball out of bounds. Is that a new emphasis?
Here comes Frank Mason in at guard to take the place of Nadir Tharp.
Is that a new emphasis? If you're shooting and you get fouled, you don't get free throws?
Don't ask me.
We'll take it.
Well, whatever works. I'm just going along trying to learn like everybody else. Duke with the ball down by one. Out front is Suleiman. Left corner shot up and missed. Rebound out of bounds to Kansas. Oh, they're going to give it to Duke. It was right here at this end. And the fans right there disputing the call.
Yeah, I think it's the right call, though. Did you see the rotation on the ball with the knuckleball? I think Andrew Wiggins got a block shot. And
he made out of the point of the shot.
Right.
Okay, here comes Seldon out now, because it went out of bounds after the shot. But if that happens, then it would be Duke's ball. They've got a new guard in the game. Thornton's back in. He started. He's the guy that hit the shot a couple of years ago at Maui out of a silo.
I mean, he was on the sideline, on the Duke bench, came out of nowhere, hadn't made a three in his career, and just put the dagger in the Jayhawks in the championship of the Maui Classic.
12:39 to play, first half. Duke with the ball, Kansas leading by one. Thornton gives the ball back to the official. Now the official gives it back to Thornton. Pass in the lane, knocked away, loose ball. KU's got it. Here comes Mason up that court in traffic. Ball blocked, but a foul.
Good job by Frank. Committed to it, got to the basket. I don't know if they're going to count it. Yep, just going to be two free throws. But he drew the contact, got it up on the glass, and he goes the line for two. Frank can really move with that basketball. He is fast. We've seen a lot of Kansas Jayhawks. No, there really wasn't many guys faster than Sharon Collins and Tyshawn Taylor, but Frank's going to make a run for their money.
Suleiman gets the foul. Here's Frank Mason at the line for two shots. The freshman puts it up there, and he got it. It rattled home. This is big-time ball here tonight in this building. On this occasion, Kansas and Duke. It was Michigan State and Kentucky earlier. Won by Sparty by four. Second free throw, Mason. He got it. Hit them both.
Got the shooter's roll. Trial by fire. Six freshmen. Throw you in your second collegiate game. 21,000 against Duke.
13-10. Kansas. Here's a shot from out front by Parker. He got it. They're going to call a foul on Kansas.
Yeah, just a little dribble handoff. He had just an inch, and two Jayhawks flew at him.
Oh, that's a three, too.
It's a three, yep. Two Jayhawks flew at him and fouled him. Worst thing you can do is foul a jump shooter. If you're going to foul him, don't let him make it.
Fouls on Jamari, his first, Jamari Traylor.
All of a sudden, we got a tie ball game.
Now Parker can untie it, and he does. He's from here in Chicago. And it's 14-13 Duke, 12-15 to play in the half. Frank Mason out front, guarded closely by Suleiman. Left side now, Andrew White's in the game. Out front, Seldon. Seldon goes to the bucket, shoots it, and got it off the glass. Tough shot.
Good, confident move, dribbled to that left block, gathered himself off the glass.
Embiid's in, Traylor, Andrew White, Seldon, and who's the other man out there? Embiid. Mason. Mason's in. A shot from out front is good. A three by Jabari Parker. His second three.
You got to know that he can step out. He's 6'8", but he can shoot it like a guard.
17-15 Duke. Mason out top. Play it to Jabari. Gives it to Seldon, who got fouled trying to go around the bend. Thornton's second foul of the ball game, and we'll get a timeout. Jayhawk basketball brought to you by the parking spot. Next time you travel out of KCI, park at the parking spot and travel to the airport in the KU team shuttles. The parking spot says we have airport parking covered. Former Duke great Grant Hill is in the building tonight. He had a rather ferocious dunk in that national championship game in 91.
That alley-oop. How many guys could have climbed the ladder and dunked it? Got it with the fingertips, and unfortunately, we as Kansas fans do see that a lot.
Let's see. KU still has Mason in the game. Embiid, Perry Ellis is back in. Wiggins is in, and the other man's Wayne Seldon. Here's Embiid with the ball going to the bucket. He's double-teamed. He throws up a brick. Rebound Kansas, and a follow goes in by Andrew Wiggins.
Yeah, Joel throws up a left-handed crazy shot, and Andrew's right there to clean it up. Perry Ellis gets the assignment of Jabari Parker. Just got to stay in front of him. You know they're going to set picks.
The game tied. Here's a shot out of the corner by Suleiman. It's a three-pointer.
Well, I talked about it in my keys. You got to find the shooters. And right now, the last three possessions, Duke scored 10 points on three threes.
20-17 Duke. Lost to the ball. Mason's been in there a long way with Tharp out of the ball game. Here's Wiggins, pull-up jumper, off the glass, missed everything. Wiggins got it back, however.
Shot clock did not reset as he didn't hit any rim, so Kansas now with 10 seconds to go.
They go inside, and Embiid didn't catch it. A wraparound pass from Perry Ellis becomes a turnover. Now Nadir Tharp will check back in.
Yeah, the double team came. It was the right decision. Perry just kind of fired it off his knees.
Rodney Hood's back in the lineup for Duke. Jefferson's back in, their starting center. Parker's still in. Rashid Suleiman, and the other man is the point guard, Quinn Cook. Four lead changes, couple of ties. Right now it's a three-point Duke lead. They've got the ball. Pass inside. Jefferson had it blocked from behind by Embiid. Taken by Kansas. Great defense by the rookie. Entry pass inside Ellis. Layup. Good!
Nice block. Good attack. Found Perry quick.
20-19 Duke. There's a pass inside and a drive and an easy bucket for Jefferson.
Yeah, got beat off the dribble pretty bad. Two guys got to help and there was no rotation.
22-19 Duke. 9:50 to play in the first half here in Chicago. 10th all-time meeting between the two schools. Men's basketball, a pass inside and an easy bucket for Wiggins.
Nice job by Joel being patient. The double team came. Andrew cut down the lane and got an easy bucket.
22-21. Duke by a point. Duke brings it left to right. Hood's got it on the perimeter against Wiggins. And a drive. Oh, and a little touch foul on Wiggins. Barely any contact there. But enough.
Well, what you got to do, I've said it many times, if they're going to call it on this end, make sure you drive the ball to the basket on the other, because these officials, if nothing else, should be consistent.
In with the KU lineup for the first time comes Brandon Green, and out comes Wiggins, who has two fouls. KU at early foul trouble with seven. 1-1 now for Rodney Hood, the 6'8 sophomore transfer from Mississippi State. His 1-1 free throw, no good. Rebound Kansas, Perry Ellis up to get it. Krzyzewski's taken some transfers of late. I said Wiggins had two, but I guess he just has one. So we'll make that correction. Here's a ball knocked out of bounds by Duke. Going for the steal was Rodney Hood. KU will keep it at midcourt. Well, that's good news. So apparently there's a foul somewhere else. Tarik Black has two. Seldon with one. Tharp with one.
Oh, you know what? They just corrected.
Nope, he does have two. Well, I would have thought I would have been able to keep track of Andrew Wiggins. So that's the bad news. There's a pass inside to Perry Ellis. It's knocked out of bounds by Duke. KU will keep it. The officials, Mike Stewart, Brian Kersey, Ray Natilli in this big ball game. Lead officials, Mike Stewart. 22-21 Duke. KU's ball with 9:04 to play in the half. Into Joel Embiid. He gives to Nadir. Tharp out front against Cook. Tharp drives it. Goes into the lane. Pull-up jumper. Switch! He got it.
What a tough shot off the left dribble. The bounce, the pull-up, and fading away. Knocked down the 18-footer.
23-22 Kansas. 8:40 to play. Rodney Hood with the ball. Suleiman, a shake and bake move out to Hood. Head and shoulder fake and a shot good in the lane by Rodney Hood.
They don't do a whole lot, but they spread you out. They dribble drive, try to find lanes, and they're finding the shooters.
24-23. Here's Seldon falling down, no whistle. KU gets the ball, shot from the corner by Green. Good! A three-pointer by Brandon Green.
Instant offense, Brandon Green. The corner, Joel, again poised underneath, didn't try to do too much, found his freshman mate for a three.
KU fans roaring here in Chicago as the Hawks take a two-point lead. Here's Hood driving, playing it inside of Jefferson, who scored it off the glass. Lots of contact there. Embiid hit the deck.
Bodies flying everywhere, but again, the dribble drive drew the pressure, and they find the open man every time.
7 points for Jefferson. They had four guys in their first game score 20 or more. How about that?
Against a really good Davidson.
Yeah, one we know is good.
It wasn't against Sisters of the Blind.
28-26. Duke, left corner Green, another three. Good! Back-to-back threes for Brandon Green.
I think that was just a two, but that was a nice recognize by Joel. The offense is kind of running through Joel right now. The double team comes, and he's doing a nice job of finding shooters.
Well, I thought he was behind the arc, but apparently not. So Duke's got it. Game tied. 7:07 to play in the half. Quinn Cook out front over to Parker. Parker against Perry Ellis. Pull-up jumper. Missing. Rebound Embiid for Kansas. Outlet pass goes to Seldon. Seldon drives up that court. Bank shot. Got it!
We're seeing Wayne Seldon grow up. Right there on the left side. Got a little contact. Strong enough to get it on the glass. Kansas up by two.
30-28. Jayhawk. Krzyzewski up. Talking to his team as they come down the court. 30-28. Back-to-back buckets by Brandon Green. Oh, a touch foul on Nadir Tharp, and they're not. If you're going to foul, you might as well knock the guy down, the way this game's being called right now.
Any type of contact they call, that's basketball. We go to the break with a touch foul, and Duke going to the line.
Second foul on Nadir. So Wiggins, Black, and Nadir all with two fouls apiece. Back in Chicago, 6:33 to play in the first half. Kansas leading Duke at the moment, 30-26. Leading scorer for the Jayhawks, how about Brandon Green with five? Wayne Seldon with seven. 4 points for Tharp. 6 points Wiggins, who's out of the game with two fouls. Perry Ellis with four. KU out-rebounding Duke, 11-7. Duke's 10 of 21. KU a scorching 13 of 19. Duke's hit four threes. KU's hit two threes.
Now you're corrected. I had Kansas at 30-28. The scoreboard was wrong. Kansas with a four-point lead as we come out of this timeout, and Duke's going to the line for a 1-1.
Free throws for Duke here. It's Cook at the line. He missed it. Rebound. Kansas. Seldon ends up with it.
Love to see those front ends getting missed. That's a break for Kansas.
Here with the ball. Here's Mason on the side. Out front it goes to Jamari Traylor. Over the top, Perry Ellis for the layup. Beautiful pass.
Bill Self loves that high-low action. Nice post feed. Finished by Perry Ellis. Got away with a little bit of a shove, too. That's a veteran.
32-26, Jayhawks. 6:05 to play in the half. Duke drives it. Now a shot from the perimeter. Missed. Rebound Kansas. The miss over there by Matt Jones, who's in their lineup. Here comes Mason. Mason over to Green, who bobbled it but got it back. They got bumped. Might have been a double dribble, too, huh? Felden with the ball, away from the basketball, foul on Duke. It's on Jabari Parker, his first. Parker's been in almost all the way. He came out very briefly, didn't he?
He did, just for about 30 seconds, but he got hot there for a couple possessions, knocked down a couple threes, and he's the real deal. Kansas will be in the bonus on the next foul, as Duke just committed their sixth.
Mason in for Tharp. Pass high post to Jamari Traylor, guarded by Parker. A couple of Chicagoans matched up.
Got a mismatch underneath. Yeah, they corrected it. Ed Thornton on Perry Ellis underneath.
Brandon Green, pull-up jumper. Missed this time. Rebound Parker from Duke.
Yeah,
that led to Quinn Cook.
Not a good shot that time. Brandon thought he was hot. Got to let the game come to you.
Here's Parker driving and scoring. Boy, is he a man. That gives him 9 points in the first half.
That's big boy right there. Drive to the basket. There was a little contact. He's strong enough to go up with the left and finish.
32-28.
Brandon's got to understand that when you're hot, just let the game come to you. Oh.
Perry, a jump hook. Got it! Up over Parker.
He got away with a couple steps that time. But again, you'll take it. Perry Ellis.
Perry's got 8 now to lead the Jayhawks. 34-28, inside 5 minutes to play in the half. Jayhawks' biggest first half lead. Here's Suleiman into the lane. He fell down, but are going to call a trip. Wayne Selden slaps his hands together, but the foul's on Mason. Frank's first. And now 9 team fouls on the Jayhawks, wearing their blue tonight, as Rashid Suleiman goes to the free throw line. He's only a sophomore. He's a highly prized recruit last year. And he missed the free throw on the rebound to Brandon Green for KU. Hawks a chance to add to their 6-point lead. 4:45 to play in the half. Brandon Green, bad pass. Threw it right to Jabari Parker. Parker brings it all the way, and he scored it. What a move.
How about that? The turnover, bad pass by Brandon Green, compounded with letting Jabari Parker put on a show in transition.
34-30. Kansas. A great play there by Jabari Parker, who now's in double figures. Green right side. We haven't seen Andrew White, have we?
We saw him briefly.
Very briefly.
And I got to think Andrew Wiggins is going to get back in this game.
I hope so. Here's Brandon Green with it, being guarded closely out on the perimeter by Matt Jones.
Under 10. Got
to
go.
8 to shoot. Here's Selden taking it to the bucket and missing. Lots of contact. No whistle. Here comes Duke. And it's knocked away. It's on the floor. Everybody goes after it. And a tie-up. And on the alternate possession,
Duke.
It'll be Duke's basketball. We got a timeout. Bob Davis along with Greg Gurley. Our producer-engineer is Bob Newton. We're in Chicago. Chicago being led by their fabulous freshman, Jabari Parker, who has off to a great start in the game. And they're down by just 4 points now. After a moment ago, they were down by 6. But now Parker with a great play to get them within a couple of buckets. And now it'll be Duke's ball on this inbounds play in a moment. Let's see who's in the KU lineup now. It'll be Andrew White is in there. Embiid, Selden, Jamari Traylor, Frank Mason. 1, 2, 3 freshmen, 2 sophomores.
See if Phil Self sits Andrew Wiggins with those 2 fouls the rest of the half or not. But he got a lot of punch out of Brandon Green in the game. So
yeah, and now Andrew White's capable of that same thing.
See if Andrew White can guard.
Here's Hood, a spin move and a shot.
Locked.
He took about 4 steps. That'll be traveling.
Good job by Andrew staying in front of him. Rodney Hood's, he's an athlete. And Andrew has improved his game so much defensively. More position defense than it is on the ball. But he did a nice job there forcing the turnover.
Mason brings it up against the veteran Quinn Cook. Right side Andrew White against Hood.
Yep, you got to call it. That's exactly what I'm talking about. Dribble drive, that wasn't much of a foul. As Kansas fans would have been upset with that, but that puts a good free throw shooter at the line.
Foul on Hood would be his first.
Initiate the contact. They're going to call it.
Let's see if Andrew can hit a couple of free throws. Andrew White, that is, who has not scored in the game. 6'6 sophomore, missed it. And it's rebounded and a foul on Jamari Traylor.
Andrew's got to be able to knock those down. He's too good of a shooter to miss that badly.
Parker will go to the line. What a bad turnaround that is. The foul on Traylor is his second. Free throw is Parker. Parker at the line, one for one in the game. He hits it. And now in comes Perry Ellis. Out goes Jamari Traylor. So it's Ellis and Embiid up front. White, Seldon, Mason. Parker got them both. Got the shooter's touch that time as it crawled in.
Four-point turnaround there. You got a good free throw shooter, and Andrew White missing the front end.
Yep.
And a tough foul on Jamari.
KU lead down to two. Over the top it goes to Jamari, who got hammered. But KU saves the ball. Out front, Perry Ellis. Ellis into the lane with a spinner. Can't score, but he's fouled.
That was Joel Embiid that got his shot blocked, but he gathered, found Perry Ellis, and going to go to the line for two.
Fouls on Josh Hairston. His second of the ball game. Now Perry Ellis will try his luck at the free throw line. He got it. Perry now at 9 first half points to lead the Jayhawks. Out comes Andrew White. In goes Brandon Green. Second free throw swishes by Ellis, who now has 10 points in the game. Perry also with three rebounds. And it's 36-32 Kansas, 3:10 to play in the half. On the baseline is Parker, guarded by Embiid. Parker takes him inside. It's stripped away and then laid in by Hairston.
Got beat badly, but a good help by Perry Ellis. Just, again, Duke, right place, right time.
But Duke got the bucket anyway. Here's Embiid with the ball on the far side. He's in trouble, guarded by Parker.
Ellis trying to call timeout.
Plays it into Perry Ellis, who got knocked to the floor. Now Duke comes away with the ball. Here comes Hood. Hood up into forecourt to Parker, who shoots it in.
Yeah, tough right there. Bill Self was trying to call timeout when Joel was trapped in the corner, but they're on the other end. They don't call it. Duke turns it into three on the other end after the turnover.
Did they call that a three?
It was.
Boy, just barely behind the line. But enough. 37-36. Duke has surged in front. Duke's ahead. 37-36. KU not too long ago was up six.
So Bill Self gets the timeout. Wishes he could have got the one called, but the referees aren't looking down here to see if the head coach wants to call a timeout. So unfortunately, another turnover for the Jayhawks that turns into a dagger on the other end as Jabari Parker hits from deep. Now see Kansas, they can gather, get the ball inside. You got Embiid and Perry Ellis, look for the high-low. Got Frank running the point.
Parker is still in the ball game. He's gone most of the way. Now KU down one with 2:30 to play in the half. Mason in forecourt to Seldon out front. They run a weave to Green. Back to Mason, head of the circle. Mason trying to get it into the lane. Shot up and crawling off, but a foul.
Had a foul on the dribble early as Frank Mason got a little leverage. He's going to go to the line.
So let's see if Frank can convert some free throws. The foul's on Quinn Cook, and that's his first. No, it's on Parker. Beg your pardon. His first. Free throw good. Parker has 16 points, 4 rebounds, 2 steals, and a block. And 1 foul. Wiggins has been riding the bench for several minutes after picking up his second foul. Mason hit them both. The Jayhawks are up by one. And Frank Mason is 4 for 4 at the line now.
Oh!
Ball out of bounds, but they give it to Duke.
Yeah, Frank Mason kind of got on that inbounds pass. Sure looked like it went off a Duke Blue Devil. Mike Stewart right there with the call.
Yeah, he's a little closer than we are here at the other end of the court.
Yeah, we're kind of up here about 15 rows up in the corner.
Go stand in the corner. I heard that a lot one time. 38-37. Here's Parker open for three. Good.
Yeah, Perry Ellis helped. And he can't leave a shooter, especially a really hot one. Perry Ellis lost him. Jabari Parker made him pay.
Parker's got 19 points in the first half. 19 of their 40. Out front with it is Seldon. Seldon trying to go toward the lane. Shoots it. It won't go. Rebound Parker for Duke. Duke by two with the ball. Here comes Rodney Hood. A steal. Frank Mason picked off a pass. Mason trying to push it up the court. Mason gives Perry Ellis. Perry with a leaner. It crawls off. Rebound. Kansas on the deck now. Perry Ellis goes down and gets it. Now inside it. it goes, and a shot missed, but a foul on Duke.
And that's on Parker. Nice job by Perry. Going to the ground, finding Frank Mason on the right block. Shot fake. Parker goes for it. He goes to the line. That was a could have been a big turnaround right there as Frank started it on one end with the steal.
You talk about 50-50 balls. Perry Ellis made that one that KU got. And back to the line is Frank Mason, who's 4-for-4 as a foul shooter. And he's 5-for-5. And the game is a one-pointer with Duke up 40-39. Now they finally take Parker out of the game. He has two fouls. And 19 points in for Kansas comes Andrew White. And Perry Ellis comes out with Parker out of the game.
We like to see that. Nice job by Perry. Created the second foul on Jabari Parker. He's got about half of their points. Good to see him on the bench for the last minute 30.
Mason converts on all the free throws. He's 6-for-6. He hit that one. Timeout, Duke. The use it or lose it timeout.
All this talk, about the emphasis and the fouls. You know, how many total? Well, I'm sorry, the stat monitor's mixed up. I'm not sure. We got over 20 fouls.
Five ties, five lead changes. Or nine lead changes with five ties. And we got a tie right now at 40-40. Monday at 6, David Lawrence has Jayhawk Sports Weekly on many of our stations. We'll set the KU lineup when they come back out on the floor. Like to see Andrew White pop in a shot or two here, wouldn't you?
I would. I'd like to see all of our shooters pop some shots in. But with Andrew Wiggins on the bench, Brandon Green and Andrew Wright got to pick up. White got to pick up the slack.
Andrew Wiggins came out of the ball game. He played just 9 minutes before coming out, so he'll be fresh for the second half. Will the Jayhawks have a tie? Will they be up or down?
The hard part's going to be is he's probably going to guard Jabari Parker and got to keep the hands off. That's going to be tough to keep him in front of you.
40-40. Duke with the ball. Ball knocked out of bounds by Brandon Green. It'll stay with Duke. Matt Jones is in. They have Hairston in. Cook, Hood, Suleiman. With Parker out of the game for Duke. Here's Cook out front. Entry pass goes into that lane to Hairston, and he missed, and a foul on Kansas. Brandon Green picks up the foul for the Jayhawks, his first. The free throw shooter is Matt Jones. I think I said Hairston. It's Jones at the line. Hairston's got a big-time beard, doesn't he? Free throw bounces off. No good. Still tied at 40 with a minute 15 to play in the half. Another free throw here for Jones, a 6'4 freshman. This one rattles out. And it's picked up off the floor by Joel Embiid. So the Jayhawks have it. Chance to go back in front. We have a minute 10 to play before halftime. Michigan State won the first game by 4 over Kentucky. Here's Andrew White out front. Pitching it over on the side to Mason. Lob inside. MB catches. Now plays to Green. Green lost it out of bounds.
Yeah, your first instinct is to shoot it. You hit two from that corner, and Brandon Green tries to do too much. And dribbles it out of bounds. Going to get our first look at Connor Francamp as he replaces Brandon Green.
We got another shooter replacing another one. 56.3 to play in the half. Duke with the ball, still tied at 40.
But you got the look you wanted. Brandon Green, a shooter in the corner, and he just doesn't take it.
A little self up. Krzyzewski's up, being very animated right now. Rodney Hood with the ball. Hood out front, spins it on the perimeter to Cook. Cook behind a ball screen, goes left side, goes to the bucket, and missed. And a foul called. Foul is on Kansas.
They're just getting to the basket too easy. The defensive breakdowns and the blow-bys, it's causing Joel to have to help, and he took the foul. So
Embiid's first foul.
And the other problem is they just got that up with 43 seconds on the clock, so they're going to get this as a kind of a two-for-one opportunity.
Shot's good by Cook, his fifth point. 41-40 Duke. Another shot for the junior point guard, Quinn Cook. It's up. Down. He made them both. And now KU down two with the ball. Cook had no turnovers in 34 minutes in their Davidson game. No turnovers. How's that? Here's a shot missing by Wayne Selden. Rebound, Joel Embiid. Back out front, Fran Camp.
It did hit the rim, though.
Fran Camp. Oh, he turned down a shot. 19 seconds. They'll go for one shot, apparently. 42-40, Duke. Down to 14 seconds. Here's Mason trying to get it in the lane. He shoots and he missed. They crash the boards. And an emphatic call by Mike Stewart gives the ball to Duke.
There were two Jayhawks going for that rebound. And I guess.
Oh, he called a foul.
Yeah, he called a foul on Embiid. They were both going after the basketball on the miss. And, oh, man, they were. I don't know how you make that call. Landon Lucas is going to play this last 6.6 after the second foul on Joel.
Wow.
Frank got all the way to the bucket. Big guy came and tried to block the shot, just couldn't get it in the hoop. And big time turnaround. But you still have 6.6 on the other end to get a good shot off.
42-40, Duke. Hairston at the line. He has 2 points. He missed the free throw, but he's got another one coming. Here comes Landon Lucas in for Kansas, replacing Joel Embiid. Hairston will shoot another one. 6'8 senior with a big beard. And he got that one to roll off.
It gotta go, gotta go.
Gotta hustle. 3 seconds. Mason up the court. Out front to Andrew White. And he missed at the horn.
He'll take it, though. Good job by Frank pushing it up. Andrew got a good look. But Kansas is going to go into the halftime with a 2-point deficit.
Dillon's the proud sponsor of the Dillon Sunflower Showdown Series. Dillon's proudly partnering with Kansas communities for over 90 years. Halftime here in Chicago, Duke 42, Kansas 40. We'll be back with our Cox Communications Halftime Show, the Jayhawk IMG Sports Network. Well, here we are at halftime as we gear for the second half. The teams are back out. KU down 42-40, but KU played with a lot of foul trouble in the first half. Meanwhile, Jabari Parker went crazy for Duke with 19 points in 17 minutes. Tarik Black played 3 minutes. He got 2 fouls and came out. Andrew Wiggins had 6 points in 9 minutes, but he came out after he got his second foul. No Jayhawk has more than two, but Black, Tharp, Wiggins, Embiid, and Traylor all with 2 fouls apiece for Duke. Parker, Thornton, and Hairston off the bench has 2 fouls. So that's the foul story as we get set. KU will be coming this direction, left to right in the second half. It'll be Wiggins, Tharp, Selden, Black, and Ellis. Hopefully the Jayhawks can get some good play out of Tarik and, of course, Andrew here in the second half.
Yeah, I got nothing out of Tarik in that first half with those two quick fouls. So love to see him be able to do something and get Andrew back in the groove early.
Andrew's going to bring it into the lane and put up a shot off the glass and in traffic.
I think he heard us. Andrew going right to the cup, spin move in the lane, avoided the charge, and off the glass.
Well, he's seen Jabari Parker score 19 first-half points. That's now 8 for Wiggins.
That had to be hard on him watching that.
Here's a pass inside, a shot block, but they're going to call a foul. Is it on Wiggins?
Nope. No, Tark.
It's on Tarik Black, and that's 3 on him.
If someone were to get 3 fouls, I would take Tark Black.
Well, they certainly have depth at that spot. At the free throw line for Duke will be Emile Jefferson, their center, who shoots it up there, and he missed it. It bounces off.
Duke really struggled from the free throw line in that first half, under 50%, 6 for 13, now 6 for 14.
Here's the next shot coming up for Jefferson. This one goes down. Jefferson now with 8 points in the ball game. He's from Philadelphia. 43-42 Duke. KU's ball. Out front is Selden. Over to Wiggins. Wiggins top of that circle. Puts up a jumper. Missing. Rebound Duke. Pulled out of there by Rodney Hood. Hood goes right to left. Hood behind the arc with a high left-handed dribble. Plays it out to the point guard Quinn Cook. Duke with the ball on a 1-point lead. Opening minute of the second half. A lob, look out, and a one-handed stuff by Jabari Parker.
Yeah, Perry Ellis, his man set the pick. He's got to help back. There really wasn't much to that. Just poor awareness by Perry Ellis.
Perry goes to the lane and got fouled by Parker, I think.
Let's see.
No, they say it's not on Parker. It's on Quinn Cook. I thought Parker clearly whacked him on the arm. Bill Self up talking to the official. He didn't quite agree with how they handled that.
Not to mention, again.
And it's not a shooting foul.
Bill Self is confused. I don't know how that's not a shooting foul.
He was clearly going up with the upward motion. And the foul on Duke. It is on Quinn Cook, his second. So KU gets the ball back, down three. Shot inside, ball deflected, but saved by Selden, who goes up and scores it off the glass.
And he got hit, too. Nice job taking that contact. Goes up with the left hand. Wayne Selden just around the basketball all half.
45-44, Duke, Duke's ball. Left side, Rodney Hood. Hood to the lane, out on the perimeter. Here's a three now. In and out, no good. Rebound Kansas on the miss by Cook. KU brings it left to right. Nadir Tharp limited in the first half due to foul trouble, like many of the Jayhawks. Ball deflected, saved by Duke. And now, but they stepped out of bounds, I think.
Yeah, he didn't reestablish. He was in bounds, but he didn't quite get that second foot down. Break for Kansas.
KU gets it under their own bucket, trailing by a point. 18:09 to play in the game. KU hoping for only its third victory ever against the Duke Blue Devils. They throw it into Tarik Black, guarded by Parker. Got Nadir Tharp with the ball on the perimeter.
Got a mismatch, Perry Ellis.
Here comes Wiggins in the lane. He can't get it to go. It spins out. Rebound Parker for Duke. Here comes Rodney Hood. Out front it goes. Parker, head and shoulder fake and a three. Missing. Rebound Kansas. Lead pass Perry Ellis. Perry brings it to the goal and lays it in. He moved around with Parker.
That almost was Jabari Parker's third foul. Nice job of pushing by Andrew Wiggins. Perry with the finish.
46-45, Jayhawks by one. 2.5 minutes into the second period. Duke with the ball. Out front, Tyler Thornton.
Tough guard for Perry Ellis, but he's doing a good job so far this half on Parker.
Here's a drive in the lane and a shot rimming in by Emil Jefferson, his 10th point.
And that's a product of Tarik Black having three fouls. Didn't move his feet, didn't want to get that fourth. Easy bucket for Duke.
Well, Jamari Traylor's already at the scoring table. 1 point lead Duke now. Here's Selden. Oh, he had a strip and a foul on Duke. It's on Thornton, I think.
No, that's a foul.
Oh, it's on Selden, who was trying to get it back.
Yeah, he wasn't strong with the ball. Thornton just ripped it, and he was forced to foul. Luckily, that wasn't a breakaway foul intentional, but on the other end, that's a product of Tarik Black having three fouls. He just went right at him. And
Tarik frustrated as he comes out of the game. Jamari Traylor in the first half played 9 minutes. No rebounds, 2 points. Duke with the ball and a one-point lead. Here's Hood leaning left side and a three by Duke is good at the Tyler Thornton's first make of the ball game.
Just a simple penetration and pitch. Dribble drive, found the shooter in the corner.
They use ball down three, down four now after the three-point bucket. Perry Ellis out top. Guarded by Jefferson, over to Selden. Selden double-teamed, out front to Nadir. Left side, Wiggins. Wiggins puts it on the floor, had it stripped out of his hands. It goes out of bounds to Kansas. 50-46, Duke, 16:21 to go. Now, Mike Stewart looking clear down at the other end of the court tells the Duke players on the bench to sit down.
Never understood that.
I don't either. I guess part of what they have to do. Here's Perry, a long one. Good! It's a three-pointer!
They went with Andrew Wiggins to the basket to defend the alley-oop. That left Perry Ellis wide open on the right wing, and he knocked down the three. And
Perry's got 15 points to lead the Jayhawks, who are down by one. There's Parker against Perry. Parker backs up on the dribble, goes to the bucket.
Oh.
They're going to call a foul. And it's on Perry Ellis. No, it's on Jamari, I think. Jamari Traylor.
Can't touch him.
I'm trying to learn to like this.
Oh, man. I don't know what that foul, how that affected play.
It doesn't
make any sense.
Our broadcast of the Champions Classic brought to you by Cadillac and your local Cadillac dealer. 15:59 to play in the game. Duke 50, Kansas 49 on the Jayhawk IMG Sports Network. 21 points for Parker for Duke. Perry leads Kansas with 15. Selden has 9. Wiggins with eight. It'll be Duke's basketball here eventually. Duke, 18 of 32, 56%. KU, 19 of 35, 54%. Neither coach will be happy with those defensive numbers, will they?
No. The two guys that have prided themselves on their success with defense.
They throw it into Rodney Hood on the wing. Hood goes to the lane for a leaner. No good, but of course a foul. Boy, these games are going to take long into the evening.
I hate to keep harping on it, but that was just a simple throw in and an easy drive to the bucket.
That's on Wayne Selden, and that's three on Wayne.
Kansas has to do a better job of keeping these guys in front of them.
Yeah, Rodney Hood, who has just 5 points, goes to the line, and he missed the free throw. And Duke at the free throw line in this ball game. Now 7 of 16. Kay has been to the line only 9 times, and they hit 8 of them. So Hood will try another one, the Mississippi State transfer. Left-handed shot goes down. He's got 6. And Duke has a 2-point lead, 51-49 with 15:50 to play. Here in Chicago, here is Nadir Tharp against Cook on the far side. Tharp goes top of the circle. Bounce pass over to Perry. Perry into the lane. Missed it. Boy, had a good close-in shot, but guarded by two Duke players, and Duke comes out of there with the ball. Here comes Hood up the court. He can't score. Rebound Perry Ellis. Perry ahead to Mason. Mason with a lob to Wiggins, and he scored it.
Not exactly picture-perfect, but Andrew Wiggins with the put down.
Andrew with 10 now, and it's 51-51.
Kind of a dunk.
It went in. You'll take it. Here's the drive and a shot. Oh, they're going to count the basket and call a foul. Whistle blew, and then the play continued.
That's a guy you don't expect. Is Emile Jefferson just off the dribble. Jamari can't keep him in front. He's got an opportunity, a three-point play.
Yeah, Jefferson's had a pretty good ball game. That's 4 fouls now in Jamari. They're going to have to get Embiid in the game. Black is on the bench with 3. Now Jamari with 4. And Jefferson to the line. He is a sophomore. His free throw goes in. It's a 3-point play, and that hurts. 54-51. Three-point Duke lead down to the 15-minute mark. Mason on the side plays to Andrew Wiggins. Puts up a jumper. In and out. Rebound. Saved by Perry Ellis, and he kept it alive. And what do they call over there? Well, out of bounds.
The ref was right there. It looked like Perry, when he threw it back in, it hit the line.
Oh, okay. The ball hit the line. Right. I couldn't see any player over the line. And it'll be Duke's ball. They're up by 3. 14:45 to go. There's a shot in the lane by Parker that hit the net, went out of bounds.
Yeah, good defense by Andrew. The post up, he got a hand up. People thought he might have got a piece of it, but great defense by Andrew Wiggins.
Parker and Wiggins are matched up right now. Now they're not. Parker comes over to guard Embiid. It'll be Hood on Wiggins. 54-51, Duke, 14 and a half minutes to play. Nadir Tharp and Mason both in the game right now. Selden out with foul trouble. Here's Wiggins trying to go inside, and he got handcuffed and fouled big time by Tyler Thornton, and that's 3 on him. That is only 2 fouls on Duke this half, 5 on Kansas. Out goes Jefferson. In for Duke comes Josh Hairston at 6'8". KU's ball, down 3. They throw it into Embiid out front. Joel needs help. He gets it to Mason for a 3. Too hard. Off the lip. Rebound Duke. Here they come up the court, and a layup is good by Quinn Cook. They tried to steal it rather than get in front of him, and now Bill Self wants a timeout. Duke up by 5 now.
Had a wide open look for Frank. He missed it and compounded it by not getting back on defense, and Duke made him pay.
14:07 to play in the game. Have your holiday photo taken with Big and Baby J. The photo session includes your group and a KU mascot. You'll receive a digital file for your holiday photos. The shoot is Sunday, November 17th, from 11 a.m. to 3 p.m. in Hadle Auditorium in the Wagnon Student Athletic Center. KU's lineup now. Wiggins, Mason, Perry Ellis, Seldon, and Embiid. That is 1, 2, 3, 4 freshmen and a sophomore. Youth being served. KU down here by 5 now. Duke's biggest lead in a while. Mason out front. This could be a big possession. We're still a long way to go, though. 14 minutes to play in the game. Perry Ellis to the Mason. Get it inside to Wiggins, who got fouled from behind by Suleiman.
Yeah, right out of the timeout, they set a play up to post Andrew up on the right block. Force Duke to foul.
Common foul. They'll play it in. That's only 3 team fouls on Duke this half. 5 on Kansas. Mason behind the end line. Throws it into Seldon, who gives it out front to Andrew Wiggins. Wiggins guarded by Suleiman. New shot clock. Right side, Perry Ellis. Perry trying to get inside, and he scores it up over Jabari Parker.
Just kept his dribble alive. Created a little space. Spun to the basket, Perry.
There's McDonald's of all Americans all over this game. Went there, 56-53, Duke.
Perry really stepping up.
Oh, steal. Mason took it away. And now he got fouled before he could get to the other end. Fouled by Quinn Cook, his third.
How about Frank Mason sparking this team? He did it in the first half, and here he is again with a big steal. Like you said, Bob, it was a 5-point game. Where's it going to go? Perry Ellis steps up. And Frank Mason gets the steal. Kansas with possession.
3-point Duke lead. Wiggins will play it on the far side.
That was close to being a breakaway foul. He grabbed him.
One more step, you know. Here's Seldon out front. Seldon plays it inside to Perry Ellis for a dunk. He soared in the air and jammed it with the right hand.
Nice pick and roll that time. Seldon found Perry Ellis. Jabari Parker doesn't want a foul. Kansas back to within one.
Mike Krzyzewski calling timeout. Wow. Each team now with 3 timeouts remaining. Wichita, Mid-Continent Airport, and Southwest Airlines invite you to nominate someone who goes above and beyond to make a difference in your community. Go to KUAthletics.com, click on Hero of the Week. We'll tell you why that person's worthy of recognition. Next game, we'll announce our Hero of the Week, brought to you by Wichita, Mid-Continent Airport, Southwest Airlines, and KU Athletics. See all the nominees featured on Facebook at Fly Wichita. What a shot by Perry Ellis. And Perry, in this ballgame now, has 9 in the second half, 19 for the game.
He really made a nice move on that left block. Previous possession, Frank gets the steal. The pick and roll, Wayne Seldon doesn't take the 3, gets the easy bucket. And again, Jabari Parker did not want to pick up his 3rd.
The Baby Jays are out there, 4 KU freshmen. Here's Hood with a leaner. Oh, and they bail him out with a foul call. Huh. He was leaning in there, and they call a foul on the Jayhawks. And Perry Ellis gets it, his 1st.
Now, it's not going to go down, and it's a block, but the ball, it would have counted if it went in. Joel's there for the block, forced Hood to make 2 free throws.
So Hood to the line, where he is 1 out of 3 in the ball game. Free throw Hood, perfect this time, from Meridian, Mississippi. And a transfer from Mississippi State. Hood will shoot another one. Knocked it in. So it's a, once again, a 3-point lead for the Dukies, 58-55. Bill Self talking to one of the officials down here. Here's Mason inside, an off-balance shot. Goes in! What a play by Little Frank!
And a ton of contact right there as Bill Self gives an earful to Mike Stewart. I mean, I don't know what you got to do. But Frank Mason stepped up and rolled one in.
Here's Parker. Parker pushing, leaning, shooting. Foul on the defender. It's going to be on Wiggins. That's, boy, that's tough.
I don't know. This
is going to take a lot of getting used to, isn't it?
It really is. We're only 2 games in, and the crowd's booing. The fans don't like it. We don't like it. I know the coaches don't like it. Man.
58-57 Duke. But Parker at the line, and he hits it.
Well, if you wanted a free throw, Thon, you're getting it.
Parker now with 22 points. He's shoot another one. He can give him a 3-point lead again. Parker is 4 for 4 at the foul line in the game. And he makes another one. 60-57 Duke. Here comes Mason. He's the point guard. Tharp is out. And Mason's played pretty well. over on the side to Seldon. Into Embiid for a slammer. He got around Parker, who's not all that much interested in playing defense right now.
Great job by Wayne Seldon, too, feeding Joel right to the bucket. Easy flush for Joel.
60-59, Duke.
Joel's really been good tonight. I know it's his first points, but...
Oh. There's a shot inside, missing badly by Duke, thrown up there by Suleiman. Here comes Seldon, and he missed a dunk. Embiid gets it, got it knocked away, plays it out front to Mason. So KU will reset here, down by a point.
Wayne just had the right idea, just wasn't high enough.
Here's Perry Ellis with the ball, far side, putting it on the floor, shooting it, in and out, no good. Rebound Duke. Here comes Rasheed Suleiman. In low it goes, and Parker misses.
Oh.
Rebound Kansas. Lead pass, and a dunk by Wiggins.
Kansas back on top. Nice pitch ahead by Perry, and Andrew with the flush.
61-60 Jayhawks. Andrew Wiggins scores it.
This crowd has got a lot of Jayhawks in it, and they are on their feet.
Wiggins now with 12, six in each half. Here's Duke with the ball. Suleiman in the lane. Plays it out on the perimeter now. For the basketball, Emile Jefferson. Now to Cook. 15 on the shot clock. KU by one. Parker. In the lane it goes, and a shot is missed. A miss by Duke. KU's got it.
Got numbers.
The miss by Jefferson. Here comes Mason up the court. Missed off the glass. Rebound Duke. That was an off-balance, tough shot. Here comes Parker. Parker with a lob. Knocked out of bounds. They'll give it to Duke. They say KU touched it last.
Almost Andrew Wiggins. Fourth foul. Nice job in transition by Andrew, knocking that ball out.
Look at Jefferson talking as he can talk. He's talking smack as he comes off the floor for Duke, yelling at one of the KU players. We've got a timeout. We need it. Membership in the KU Alumni Association, the single most powerful way to make all of KU stronger, because everything they do strengthens KU. Bob Davis, Greg Gurley, producer-engineer Bob Newton. KU has roared back to take a one-point lead. Duke led at halftime, 42-40. We had half a dozen ties, a dozen lead changes. KU's led by six. Duke is led by six. How close it's been, and we still have 10:48 to play in the ballgame. The first game tonight went to Michigan State over that young Kentucky team, 78-74. KU now. They've announced the attendance, 22,711. Kansas shooting 53%, Duke 51%. Rebounding, KU 27, Duke 19. There's a miss by Duke. KU's got the rebound. They with a one-point lead in the ball. Here they come. Mason bobbled it, but got it back. Out to Nadir Tharp, who's in. Mason in the corner. Takes it to the goal. And got it and won.
Nope, didn't go in.
It didn't?
No.
I thought it went right in.
But
let's count it anyway.
He gave up the three, dribbled hard to the basket, created the contact.
How did that not go in?
Yeah.
Foul is on Duke, and it's on Jefferson, his third. Well, Frank, 6-for-6 at the foul line. Let's see how he does here. Missed it. Boy, that looked like it went in the basket.
It did.
We have kind of a tough angle here behind the bucket. But
yeah, the right corner of the backboard kind of blocks us out here, 15 rows back.
Yeah, it does. Second shot. Perfect this time. And Mason now with nine. He and Nadir Tharp both in the game, along with Perry Ellis, Wayne Seldon, and Joel Embiid. Wiggins has gone out. Mark Traylor's out with foul trouble. So is Tariq Black. Here's Parker. They play it on the perimeter. That nearly was a walk by Hood. Played it over to Cook. 10-15 to go. KU by two. Duke trying to spread things out, get a lob perhaps. Here's a drive by Cook. Shot missed, but it's stuffed in there by Emile Jefferson.
Yeah, I think that was a shot, too. It looked like an alley-oop, but it was a shot. Emile Jefferson just right place, right time.
62-62. Perry Ellis in low against three defenders. Got it to go!
And Perry Ellis is operating underneath. A lot of contact. No call. Bill Self is hot. But Perry Ellis doesn't care. He just keeps scoring buckets.
21 for Perry. KU leads by two. Dukes with the ball. Right side, Quinn Cook. Foot comes out top to Jamari Parker. Now on the left side to Rodney Hood, looking to Parker. Parker in the lane, posts up, missed. Rebound Kansas. Here comes Nadir Tharp, then he lost it. He got it back. He beat the defender to the ball. Far corner, bats bad pass out of bounds, trying to get it over there to Frank Mason.
And I don't know what Nadir's doing. He is struggling tonight. That's a play you just pull out. There was nothing happening. Duke was back on defense. And
Parker's going out of the Duke lineup, Greg. Josh Hairston replaces him.
Yeah, he's got 4 points here in the second half. He's got an alley-oop and two free throws. So Kansas doing a much better job on him defensively.
9-10 to play in the game. KU by two, Duke's ball. Who will they go to without Parker in there? Here's Hood. Hood banged into Seldon, but no, nothing called. Now Seldon to the lane. Or Hood, I should say. And a shot goes in and a foul.
I don't know what to say.
I don't either.
I mean, we're seeing all kinds of contact down here.
It's interesting. 10 points now for Hood. The foul is on Perry, his second. Bill Self appealing his case down there. Krzyzewski's up, choreographing at the other end of the court. So now it's a tie game, and Duke can take the lead as Hood looks for a three-point play. Hood 3-for-6 at the line. Now he hits this one. And it's Duke by one with 9 minutes to play. 65-64. Wiggins is back in the KU lineup with Embiid, Seldon, Tharp,
well, here's what
and
you
Ellis.
Do. Go right at him. They're going to call it dribble right at him.
I don't know.
Oh, there you go.
What? A little touch foul on Duke this time, and it's on Josh Hairston. I think he gave him a hip, really, as Nadir went around him.
Right.
So there was contact, and that is foul number 6 on Duke. So KU's still not in the bonus. KU has 8 fouls this half. They'll give it to Wiggins to play in. KU down 1, 8:47 to go. Ball inbounds, knocked out of bounds by Rodney Hood, or rather, Quinn Cook, I beg your pardon. KU's ball. They're down at this end this half. Going left to right. Wiggins will trigger. Into Nadir. Nadir out top of the circle. Guarded by Quinn Cook. Nadir goes to the side. Out front, Joel Embiid. In the lane it goes Wiggins. Wiggins missed inside, but tipped in his own miss.
He's so quick off his feet after he missed that. Pogo's stick right back up and in for the offensive rebound. Put back. Kansas back by one.
8 in the second half for Wiggins. 14 for the game. KU by a point. Here's contact, and a shot goes in by Duke. No whistle. Suleiman scores it.
Nice move that time, and that's basketball. He
that's all right. I like that.
I like they didn't call foul either way.
Yeah, probably the best you can hope for. So this thing just kind of evened out here as the season moves along.
Perrigan. No one guarding him out there. He's already hit it. 1-3.
Here's a pass inside, and before Wiggins can score, they call a foul on Duke Thornton. That cost KU 2 points. Thornton's fourth foul. Timeout. The Williams Education Fund, the fundraising arm of KU Athletics, supporting 500-plus KU student-athletes, invites you to join. A Williams Fund membership provides the necessary resources to advance KU Athletics in the classroom and competition. For more information, visit williamsfund.com. 7:59 to play. Duke, 67. Kansas, 66. You're listening to Jayhawk basketball. Quite a ball game here featuring two of the winningest programs all time in college basketball, Kansas and Duke. It's 7:59 to play. Duke up by one right now, 67-66. And out comes Parker back into their lineup. Rodney Hood is there. Rashid Suleiman, Cook, and the other man would be Jefferson. So Suleiman's in for Thornton. Otherwise, the four other starters are in. Suleiman's the same as a starter. Free throws coming to Kansas. And it will be Andrew Wiggins at the line. Andrew's first trip to the foul line tonight, and it's a two-shot foul. First of which missed. Rebound.
It's a 1-1.
Yep, it's a 1-1, and Duke got it. So Andrew missing his first free throw try, and now Duke with a one-point lead and the ball. 67-66. Here's the drive inside and a shot that rims out by Duke, put up there by Suleiman. KU brings it the other way. Here comes Nadir. Inside now to Embiid. Embiid plays to Wiggins for a 10-footer. No, but a foul on Duke. It's on Hood, I think. Yep. Hood. It's only his second foul. So Wiggins goes back to the line. Let's see if Andrew could knock in a couple here. KU down one. Free throw Wiggins. Perfect this time. So he's got 9 in the second half. 15 for the ball game. He had 16 against Louisiana at Monroe, and he makes both free throws. The Hawks move in front by one with 7:30 to go. 68-67 Jayhawks. Here is Cook out front. Looks to Hood. Hood on the side. Guarded by Seldon. Pass inside now. Jefferson. Shot blocked by Embiid. Out of bounds, but a foul.
They got a foul on Andrew Wiggins as he stood his ground, almost took a charge, and Embiid blocked the shot. Not sure what he did.
Bill Self's asking the same thing. Wow. Jefferson to the line for two shots, and Wiggins now with four fouls. 7:20 to play. Free throw. Missing. They'll try another one for Jefferson. Jefferson tonight at the foul line is 3 of 5 with 15 points. There's Mason in. Wiggins will have to come out. And Andrew a little frustrated after that foul call. 68-67. KU second shot. Missing. He missed them both. And KU's Perry Ellis has the rebound.
It's karma.
Duke is now 14 of 25 at the foul line.
Bad call. Kansas got a break with the two missed free throws.
Here's Embiid inside getting hammered. He'll go to the line.
They had to call that. It probably wasn't even a foul, but they wouldn't have called that. You would have might have seen a technical by Bill Self, and this time they probably would have called it, unlike Friday night in the Louisiana Monroe game. So Joel go to the line for two. Kansas now will be in the double bonus the rest of the way.
I think the foul was on Parker, wasn't it? They've not posted it as yet. So here is Embiid at the free throw line, and he threw up a brick. No good. Wow.
Bright lights got him.
Joel will try another one. He goes a little shadow box here. Now he'll see if he can extend KU's lead to 2 points. Foul shot. Missed. He missed them both, and neither team making free throws right now. Foul was on Parker. They now have posted it. It's his third. So Parker against Ellis at the other end. Parker turns.
Perry knocked it away. Loose ball. Picked up by Kansas. Here comes Seldon up the court, and he got pushed. Nothing called. Oh, my goodness. And the KU bench erupts.
They're going to correct it. They're going to correct it.
The other official comes in.
Yep.
And now they give it to Kansas. It really should have been a foul.
I'm not sure how the official right in front of it didn't see it. The one from behind had to make the call. But we're glad he stepped up and made that.
At least the KU gets the ball. They're up by 1 point after all that. Well, it's early in the season for the officials, too, right?
Right.
Here's Seldon out front to Nadir Tharp. KU needs a bucket here. Big clutch basket from somebody. Wiggins on the bench. Here's Mason playing it into Perry, and Perry got pushed and fouled. Who will they pick out this time? It is on Rodney Hood, his third. KU in the bonus, and Perry will go to the line. Boy, what a game for Perry Ellis. 11 in the second half, 21 for the ball game. And at the line, 2 for 2. His free throw. Perfect. Perry has another point. KU leads 69-67.
If you're wondering about career highs, Perry Ellis last year, 23 points against Iowa State.
Yep. Second free throw goes in. I was in the Sprint Center in the conference tournament. KU 70, Duke 67. KU fans leap to their feet. 6:25 to go. Ball knocked away. Oh, they called a foul on Mason. Trying for a steal.
A play that had, again, no effect.
None.
The ball went out of bounds. Would have been Duke's ball. Oh, it's exhausting.
It is.
Mentally draining.
Yeah.
And it kills any momentum in this game.
The idea of this is to get the flow back into the game.
And that's one that you could just move on, throw it out of bounds, go inside.
Free throw, bouncing in for Suleiman. 70-68. One saving grace, at least to this point, Duke has not done a good job at the line. They've been up there a lot. Much more than Kansas. Second free throw good by Suleiman, who's now 2 for 4. And now we'll get a timeout.
This is a 30-second timeout.
So it's going to be a 30-second timeout, so we'll stay right here. Day or night, Country Lane or City Streets, buckle up every trip, every time. In Kansas, it's Click It or Ticket. A reminder from the Kansas Department of Transportation and your Kansas law enforcement community. Well, we'll see when we get to December and January and into February how this will start to look.
Yeah, and that's the frustrating part. If they start to call it differently,
yeah,
then all the things you might have adjusted to and adapted to just goes to waste, and then you get into March, and we got the same old thing. And I don't think it was that bad. It was physical, and you can clean up a few things, but
yep,
you got to baby step it. There's no way you can just go from one extreme to the other just because a committee decides it.
Yeah, you really have a little compassion for the officials who are trying to make an adjustment as well.
Yeah, I mean, it's to a degree, it's not their fault because they're told what to do. But
yeah,
bottom line, we got 6 minutes and 20 seconds against Duke, up one with the ball.
Frank Mason out front. He and Tharp are both in the game. Embiid's in the game. Perry Ellis, Wayne Selden. Selden nearly had it hammered away. Plays to Mason. Mason into that lane for a shot. Good in traffic. He shot it in against Jabari Parker.
How about Frank Mason growing up right in front of our eyes, just like Wayne Selden, everybody else. Frank Mason having a career night.
72-60. Well, he's had a short career.
Well,
here's Parker. Parker runs into the lane and scores it with a big swinging hook.
That's a big-time move right there. He's fading away from about 10 feet with kind of the finger roll. That's just a big-time shot.
72-71. Kansas, 5:40 to go. Here's Mason again. Out on the perimeter to Nadir Tharp. Tharp backs up, guarded by Quinn Cook. 20 on the shot clock. Nadir goes to the elbow, out to Embiid for a three that's going to miss. Well, that's a bad-looking shot.
Yeah, and that's a bad time for that shot. He just bricked a couple free throws. That basically got nothing going outside. You don't want that shot.
Now Duke's got the ball down by one with 5:12 to play. Here's Parker. Parker goes up for a shot. Got it. A two. Look at Krzyzewski leaping in the air over there, firing off their bench. Wow,
Frank Mason kind of got caught in it. Got bumped by Emile Jefferson, who's been very vocal all night. But Jabari Parker had kind of a pedestrian first 15 minutes of this half, 14 minutes now. This last minute, he's really shown up. Had the running one-hander, then he knocked down the 17-footer over the outstretched arms of Joel Embiid.
He's got 27. Perry Ellis leads Kansas with 23. Duke by one with 5:06 to go. And Parker is as good as advertised, maybe better.
No, I think better. I didn't know what to expect. I know he was good, but
yeah,
he's shown it inside.
He got hurt his senior year in high school and was kind of limited. And, you know, he was everybody's guy as a junior. Of course, Wiggins then decided to actually came out of high school a year earlier than they originally expected.
And he shares a feat. I believe he won 4 state championships in Illinois high school basketball as well.
Like Perry Ellis,
you talk about a competitive state.
At Simeon.
Yep.
So it'll be KU's ball in backcourt, and Duke's going to press. Mason and Nadir both in the game. So is Selden. So 3 ball handlers. Nadir will bring it down to the 5-minute mark. 73-72 Kansas, bound by one. Duke leading by a point. Here's Frank Mason. Mason, top of the circle, over to Nadir Tharp. Tharp against Cook. Tharp takes it into that lane, and a foul. He took it to the goal. Couldn't score, but he got fouled, and the foul is on Cook, and that's 4 on him now.
They're trying to post Andrew up, and Nadir found a lane, got to the basket. Not having a great game. Has an opportunity, though, to give his team another lead.
Oh, take that back. That's 3 fouls on Cook. I'm sorry. 3 fouls. 2 shots for Nadir. Nadir has only 4 points in the game. He has not been to the foul line until now. 2 shots coming. Duke by a point. Free throw. Rattles in. The game is tied. In for Duke comes Tyler Thornton. Out goes Jefferson. So they'll go smaller here.
The real question for Bill Self is, what are you going to do on the other end? Jabari Parker starting to feel it. who gets the assignment. Andrew Wiggins has four fouls, has to be very careful. Perry Ellis is going to have to man up.
Wiggins is back in.
Yep.
Along with Tharp, Mason, Seldon, Perry Ellis. Another free throw for Nadir. He can give KU the lead back here with an opportunity to break the tie. Long look at it. Here's the free throw. He nailed it. And Nadir Tharp now with six, and it's 74-73 Kansas. 4:45 to play in the game.
Wayne Seldon on Parker out front.
Here's Parker, head of the circle, guarded by Perry. Long three. Missed. Rebound. Kansas, and somebody was on a back down there.
Yep, I think Wayne Seldon's going to go to the line.
Foul was on Hood, Rodney Hood.
Got a hand up on Parker, took an ill-advised shot, but he does have the hot hand. Big swing right there as Wayne Seldon goes the line.
Four fouls on Hood. Seldon has not shot a free throw tonight. He'll shoot it right here. Both teams are in the double bonus now. Seldon was not very good at the line the other night, 1 out of 5. Big free throws here as the Let's Go Jayhawks resonates here at the United Center. Seldon buries the free throw. 75-73, Kansas, 4:35 to play. Michigan State beat Kentucky 78-74 earlier. Second free throw, Wayne Seldon. Count it! He made them both. 76-73 Jayhawks. 4:30 to play. Here comes Duke right to left. Quinn Cook out front. Where's Parker? Parker goes to the left corner. A drive and a shot inside is good by Suleiman. And they called a foul. Can you just shoot a basket anymore?
As Frank Mason was retreating.
Bill Self shaking his head as he comes back the other direction. Now Duke can tie it with a three-point play for Suleiman, who has 6 in the second half, 9 for the game. He had 20 off the bench the other night in their ball game. And it's up, and it's bouncing off. No good. KU still up by 1. Wiggins got the rebound. 4:15 to go. 76-75 Kansas. Bill Self clapping his hands as his team comes up. Here's Nadir over to Perry. Perry Ellis with the ball against Parker. Back out to Nadir Tharp. 4 minutes to play. 15 on the shot clock. Ellis inside. Can't score, but Parker fouled him, I think.
Yep,
he did. Perry. I knew there was a foul, but it is on Parker, and that's 4 on him.
Perry
may be hurt.
Down. Looked like he tweaked that ankle, but he's going to go to the free throw line.
Oh, boy.
Yeah, they're stretching out. Going to get a break here after these free throws and a dead ball. Perry limping to the free throw line, but what a warrior tonight, Perry Ellis.
4 fouls on Parker, 4 on Hood. The only Jayhawk with 4 right now who's on the floor is Andrew Wiggins.
You can now.
Perry stretching out that leg.
Get a guy to the scorer's table. He's tough enough to make a couple free throws, make the second one, get a spot on the bench, get the media timeout.
2 free throws for Perry. Perry in the ball game, 23 points. Tamari Parker leads in scoring with 27 for Duke. The free throw sticks between the rim and the glass.
That is hard to do. I can't remember the last time I've seen that.
You can't do it on purpose, I can tell you that.
Make this one and build this lead out to a couple and go stretch out.
Perry shoots. Perry hits it. 24 for Perry Ellis. He'll come out for a little while. Jamari Traylor goes in. Will Jamari be guarding Jabari? This is a new career high for Perry, right? He had 23 against Iowa State. So now it's Duke's ball. Here's Suleiman, a turnaround. Perfect. Boy, he just went to work one-on-one.
He kind of backed Frank Mason down to a semi-post position and just shot over.
Game tied at 77. 3:40 to play. Here's Nadir Tharp over to Jamari. Far corner, Wayne Seldon. Seldon puts it on the floor, trying to get it to Wiggins. Wiggins double-teamed in on the low blocks. Out to Seldon on the side. Seldon going inside. And shot blocked, but a foul. Who's it on?
I think it's on Hood. That's 5.
It's either Hood or Parker. They both have 4. It's on Hood. And he'll be coming out as we get a timeout. Stay after the game, the Kansas Lottery Jayhawk Locker Room Show with David and Josh, live from the Bird Dog Bar, your official away game between Duke and Kansas. Duke has won 7 of the first 9.
Yeah, not to mention Kansas 0-2 in the Champions Classic, so really like to see them pull this one out. Wayne Selden's going to be at the line for 2 after he drove to the basket. And again, just drive to the basket. They're going to call something. They're going to do it on both ends. It's going to turn into a free throw contest, but right now Kansas has the edge from the free throw line.
Selden 2-for-2 as a foul shooter. He hit a pair not too long ago. He has 11 points in the ball game. As he goes to the line here for 2 shots. Andrew Wiggins is in. Traylor, Selden, Mason, and Tharp. 22,711 the attendance. Free throw good by Wayne. 22,711. That's a sellout here at United Center. Second free throw, Selden. Got them both. KU leads by 2. Wow. How good is this? 3:20 to play in the game. Duke with the ball. They go right to left. Out front with it is Hood. Hood's still in the game. And a follow is good by Jefferson.
Yeah, good first shot defense and allowed the offensive rebound by Jefferson. He's had himself a game tonight in a mop-up role.
They have Hood with 4 fouls, so he's still in the ball game. Mason drives inside. He can't score, but it's tipped in by Selden.
Frank Mason with a whirling shot underneath, and Wayne Selden there to tip it in.
81-79, Kansas, 2:40 to play.
Got to get one stop.
Yep, this would be it right here. Here's Suleiman, a 3. No, he missed it. Rebound Selden for Kansas.
Wayne Selden
stepping up big.
It
was kind of a ill-advised 3, wasn't it?
It was. If I'm Mike Krzyzewski, I want Jabari Parker shooting those.
81-79, KU with the lead in the ball, down to 2:22 to go. Another golden possession. Jamari plays it out front to Frank Mason. Well, back to Jamari. Over on the far side, Selden. They're looking in low to Wiggins, who's being fronted inside. There's a drive by Jamari, and he laid it in!
The one guy Coach K didn't think was going to do it. Nice move by Jamari to the bucket. Kansas by 4, 2 minutes.
2 minutes to go, 83-79. Here's Hood on the perimeter to Suleiman. Suleiman in the lane. It crawls in. He got it. And a timeout. Well, what a game. Minute 51 to go.
How big was that by Suleiman?
That foul a moment ago was on number 3, Thornton, rather than number 5. Good. I didn't see Thornton close to the play, but I guess he was.
What a big play by Suleiman there. Duke down by 4. Wheels starting to come off a little bit, and he rolls one in. Mike Krzyzewski gets a quick timeout. But Kansas with the ball, minute 51, and a 2-point lead.
Duke has 1 timeout remaining. KU still has 2. And another big possession coming up for the Jayhawks. A minute 51 to go. Both teams in the double bonus. Should there be a foul?
The last couple times out of timeouts, they've posted Andrew Wiggins up, unable to get it to him because the other guy from the weak side tries to double. But what that's done is created some lanes. Frank Mason got to the lane, missed the shot, but the tip in. So when you double team, that leaves something open. So Andrew Wiggins is having an effect on this game even when he's not scoring.
Andrew has scored 10 in the second half, 16 for the ball game. It's a 2-point KU lead, a minute 51 to play. Parker has 27 for Duke. Perry Ellis still out of the game. Remember, he hurt his leg or something, and they took him out after the free throws, and now he's back on the floor. So it's Ellis, Wiggins, Mason, Tharp, and Selden. It'll be KU's ball in backcourt. Duke will pressure. KU with 3 good ball handlers out there. We'll see if they get up the floor. That's the first object. Duke pressuring, and it comes to Frank. Mason guarded by the veteran Quinn Cook. Walking dribble into forecourt. Frank Mason down to a minute 44 to play. 83-81 Kansas. Duke man-to-man, and they're pressuring. Here's Nadir Tharp out front against Suleiman, who is 6'4". Wiggins has it. Fadeaway jumper. Good! He hit it from the right side!
side.
Big boy shot that time by Andrew. The step back, that's a next level move.
85-81 Kansas. Now how about a stop? They got one. Perry Ellis, lead pass. Wiggins for the dunk. KU by six.
Oh, and a foul.
And one.
The steal by Perry Ellis. Andrew leaks out.
87-81, Kansas, a minute 17 to go.
We couldn't hear the whistle because the crowd was still going after the previous shot. Andrew gets out in open space and finishes. Kansas by six, about to make it seven. Could be a three-possession game.
You know, Wiggins, that was a crucial outside shot. He's kind of a work in progress with the outside shot, but he buried that. Then he gets a dunk and got fouled.
Hasn't really got it going from the outside. Most of his buckets has been in the lane, but he steps out, has the confidence, about an 18-foot
fadeaway. This could make it a three-possession game if he hits this one. He missed it. Rebound, Kansas. Wiggins ended up with it. Well, he can use some clock. Down to a minute 10. They're up by six. Will Duke foul him?
Doesn't look like it.
Minute five. Down to 22 on the shot clock. Nadir Tharp out front. Now foul called on Suleiman.
And a good free throw shooter going to the line. 15 seconds off the clock on the offensive rebound by Andrew.
62 seconds to play. 87-81 Kansas. Bill Self 0-3 against Mike Krzyzewski. I don't think they had one-on-one games. I just think it was their teams involved.
Bill would take them.
Oh, yeah. He would now. He'd post him up. Here's Tharp at the line. Nadir, 2-for-2 as a foul shooter. Missed it off the back iron. Well, this is the big one. You got to get that three-possession lead here. 87-81. Nadir will take a deep breath.
And Duke's going to be forced to foul whether they make it or not. Pretty big deficit. Nadir's got to make this one, though.
Big free throw. He studies it. He bends at the knees. He hit it.
Just keep guys in front of you. Don't help.
Yeah, don't foul him if you can avoid it. 88-81. In the lane goes Cook, and he laid it in. He took it all the way to the basket.
Well, I guess you'll take that. That was too easy and too quick, but it wasn't a three.
55.5 to go. Now it's a five-point game. We'll keep it right here.
What you do if you're Mike Krzyzewski, then you bring full court pressure. You try to get a trap, try to get a steal, and if you can't, there's plenty of time. You can attempt to get the steal, but then you got to take the foul.
Cook has 10 points in the ball game by my count with that bucket. He's a good veteran point guard, very solid. I tell you, this has been quite a night for some KU freshmen. Obviously, Wiggins has been a big part of it. Wayne Selden. But Frank Mason, boy, he has stepped in there in the clutch, played a lot of minutes in this game, and we still have 55.5 to go. So you'd like to use as much time as you can here, but Duke can only let them go so far before they either stop them or have to foul.
Yeah, they can't let this go down to 20 seconds, so they're going to have to try to get a couple steals, then make the foul. But Kansas proved all night that they can knock free throws down. Bill Self has the luxury of having 2 point guards in there with Frank Mason and Nadir Tharp.
Wiggins now with 20 points. That would be a career high. He had only 6 in the first half because he had foul trouble. And there's a backcourt foul as Cook.
I'm surprised there. They
fouls
Cook,
Mason.
Cook fouled him early. They only let a couple seconds go off. They didn't try to get a steal or anything. I guess he just, Coach K, can't question him. The guy's the all-time winningest coach in the history of our game. But
well, Mason was 6-for-6 in the first half, but 1-for-3 in the second half at the foul line. 2 shots for Frank. Could really use both of them, obviously. 53.9. That took a couple of seconds off the clock, and Mason calmly swishes the free throw. Big difference in this game, if KU can win it, will be the free throw shooting. Mason will shoot another one, 89-83 Kansas for the three-possession lead, and he got it. 90-83 Kansas.
You can trade buckets at this point.
Here's Cook driving inside. Missed. Tip, no. Rebound, Kansas. Foul on Duke. He was trying to get out of there with the ball, but a foul, and it's on Suleiman.
I'm surprised they're not trying to shoot the three at
look
all.
Look at Krzyzewski comes over to talk to lead official Mike Stewart.
And they give Mike Krzyzewski the time to talk to him. They look at Bill Self, tell him to sit down. I guess you got to approach 1,000 wins and you get a little leeway. But
Yeah.
Bill's getting there. How about 300 wins over his first 10 years at Kansas?
45.1 to go. KU by 7. Two free throws for Andrew Wiggins. Wiggins with 20 points. His free throw gives him 21.
Well, Jabari Parker had it going on in the first half. Andrew Wiggins in these final 3 minutes has really risen.
91-83 KU. Second shot. Perfect. What a night for these young Jayhawks. They're up by 9. Here's Cook. A pull-up shot off the glass. No. Rebound. Duke. Followed by Hood. Stolen. Nadir Tharp took it away from him. Lead pass comes to Mason. Mason is fouled as he crossed midcourt. 28.7, and listen to the Rock Chalk chant here in the Windy City.
I love that sound, waving the wheat, singing the Rock Chalk chant.
Foul on Alex Murphy, who came in to be the designated fouler off the bench.
It's getting down to time where you just dribble it out, take your lumps, head home. Kansas will not be 0-3 in the Champions Classic.
Mason hits the free throw. We've seen a lot of Mason and Tharp in the game together. Another free throw. Up. Mason. Got it. Two at the line by Frank. 94-83. 25 seconds to go. Duke in a hurry. Suleiman, long three. Missing. Rebound taken by Wayne Selden. Kansas has this ball game. And the ball knocked out of bounds by Duke. KU will throw it in with 15.9 to go. The Jayhawks will be 2-0, and they will have knocked off Duke.
It's going to be a late night, but it's going to be a fun ride home.
94-83 Kansas. They throw it into Mason. 12 seconds. Mason across midcourt. They're not going to foul now. 8 seconds. Mason over to Tharp. 5 seconds. Time running out. The Jayhawks have knocked off the Duke Blue Devils. The final, 94-83, as Bill Self and Mike Krzyzewski have a quick handshake. The Jayhawks win it.
What a great effort by Kansas. Touch and go all night. Ton of lead changes. Andrew Wiggins steps up. Wayne Selden steps up. Frank Mason. Gotta love those three freshmen tonight.
And you get to go downstairs and interview Bill Self.
I'll be right back.
See what he thinks of this ball game. Jayhawks with a win here tonight. A huge win here to go 2-0 on the new season.